Hello, in this video you will learn about gravitational search algorithm topics that are covered in this video. First, we will understand basic fundamentals of force, what is gravity and what is gravitational force. After that, what is gravitational search algorithm, and we will try to understand this algorithm step by step with example. We will learn how we can initialize the population randomly, how we can calculate the fitness values, how we can calculate velocity, force, mass and acceleration, and how we can update the values for each search agent. So this is gravitational search algorithm that is implemented by Newton's gravitational law, and this is new optimization algorithm based on law of gravity and mass. First, we'll understand basic concept like what is force. As we all know, this is push or pull of an object. When we push or pull any object, there is force. Now, what is gravity? Gravity is the force of attraction between you and Earth. On planet Earth, gravity gives weight to the physical bodies. In the outer space, there is no gravity. That's why human weight in space is zero, because there is no gravity. As the distance from the Earth increases, gravity decreases. That's why in the space, human weight is equal to zero, as there is no gravity, because gravity gives weight to physical bodies. Now, what is gravitational force? First, we'll understand how we can compute force. Now, force acting on a particle surface is F equal to mg. Here, m is the mass and g is the gravitational force. Suppose we have a particle having mass, and this is the gravitational force, g, acting on the particle surface. According to gravitational force, every particle in the universe attracts every other particle having mass. So what is gravitational force? This is the attractive force between two masses separated by distance r. And this is the equation that we use to compute gravitational force, or simple force. Here g is the universal gravitational constant. F is the force, R is the distance, M1, M2 is the mass. Here, negative sign indicate that the force is negative. Now, how we can calculate the gravitational force? That is, suppose for two particles we have mass, M1, M2, and this is the distance, and we have gravitational constant value as this one. Using this equation, we can compute the gravitational force. So, every particle in the universe attract every other particle with a force that is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. In the gravitational search algorithm, gravitational means central force that is attractive in nature and worked on by it is independent of the path followed. As this force is conservative force, so it is independent of the presence of other bodies around. Gravitational force example, like you can see here, force that cause apple fall downward from the tree, or you can say force that keep you walking on earth instead of floating away into space. As in the space, there is no gravity, human bodies float. On earth, gravity gives weight to the physical bodies. So in this algorithm, agents are considered as object, and object performance is measured by their masses. Heavy mass means good solution, that means it is the better one. And objects can attract each other with the help of gravitational force. It causes the movement of the object toward the heavier masses. And when the object or agent with heavy masses moves slowly, that is the exploitation step in the GSA algorithm. Now we have certain question answer that is important. First question is where we can use this algorithm. We can use this algorithm to solve complex optimization problems. How this algorithm is constructed? By the law of gravity. How we can calculate mass? With the help of fitness function, we can calculate mass. And what is search agent or simple agent in this algorithm? we will consider objects as agent. That is the solution for optimization problem, and they know their current position. Now next is, when gravitational search algorithm will stop? During each generation, when all objects will gather on same point, that's the stopping point. How we can update the position by obtain? For that we will obtain new position. In this algorithm, each search agent have three parameter: position, mass, active and passive gravitational masses. And here agent is the possible solution in the optimization, and they know their current position and mass. Now next question is, how we can calculate mass? For that we will use this equation. For minimization, we will consider minimum fitness value best and maximum fitness value as breast. And for maximization, we will consider minimum value as breast and maximum value best. For force calculation, we can use this equation, that is the attractive force between the two masses. So for the force calculation, we can use this equation. Here this is the passive gravitational mass, and this is the active gravitational mass, and this is the Euclidean distance between two agents. We just transform this equation into this one. Next is position and velocity calculation. For that we will use this equation and this one. In order to compute velocity, you can see we will use this equation. Here this is the random value and interval, you can take the values in between 0 and 1, and velocity and plus acceleration, and we can update position by adding some velocity in the previous position. So this is gravitational search algorithm. First step is initialization phase. Second is, we will generate population randomly for the each search agent of size n. After that we will evaluate the fitness value for the each search agent, and we will set the counter. After that we will check the best and the worst in the population. Then we will calculate the gravitational constant, mass, acceleration, force for the current population, and after that we will update the position and velocity for the each search agent, and again we will evaluate the fitness values, and we will repeat this process until stopping criteria match, and in the end we will return the best solution. So let's start this with an example. First step is population initialization phase. Here we will initialize the population for n search agents. Here this is the position of the search agent. I will consider here 4 search agent, so value for n is 4. I'm using just 4 objects. So we have population of 4 search agent, I equal to 1 to 4. We have x1, x2, x3 and x4. And the domain I'm using for minus 100 to 100. Here low is minus 100, high is 100. In MATLAB you can write this equation and you can get the initial population randomly. So step 1 is done. We randomly generated population for n search agent. Now next step is evaluate the fitness value for each search agent. Here you can see I'm using this fitness function to calculate the fitness value. Using this fitness function, we can compute the fitness value for first search agent, second, third and fourth. Here we will put the values, and you can see here we computed the fitness value for the each search agent. Step 3 is done. We successfully computed the fitness value for the each search agent, and next step is set counter 0. So initially we have counter T, that is first iteration is 0. Now next step is update best and worst value in the population. So we will consider, as this is optimization algorithm and we are doing here optimization, so for minimization we will consider minimum fitness value best and maximum fitness value worst. Done. Step 5 is done. We have best and worst values. Now next step is we will compute G, mass, acceleration, force. So in order to compute gravitational constant, we will use this equation. As you can see here, value of alpha is 20. This is first iteration, 0. Value for G naught is 100. As you can see, I computed value for G for first four iterations. We will use for the first iteration, that is t equal to 0, I will use this value. Now next question is how we can calculate mass using fitness function. We can compute mass, so we can calculate mass using fitness values. As you can see here, mass is calculated by agent's fitness value. So this is the fitness value for the agent, and this is the worst, that is the maximum fitness value, and this is the best, that is the minimum fitness value. So for this, put the values here in this equation. For example, for the first search agent, I will put the fitness value, this one, 3.920 here, and the worst fitness value is this one, put the value here, and the best fitness value is this one, put this value here, and worst value, and you will got this. So this is the mass for first agent, second, third, and fourth. Now next is force calculation. You can calculate force using this equation. So in order to compute force, we will use this equation, and to improve this algorithm performance, first we need to compute k best value. That is, only k best agent will attract other. That is, value decreases with time, and in the last iteration only 2% agent apply force to other. As you can see, we are using a 1000 iteration. In the end, we will got only 2% agent that will apply force to other. Now next step is force calculation. For this, you can see here in this equation, we have value for gravitational constant that we computed recently. We have value for active and passive mass. We know the position, but we don't know the distance. So first we will compute the distance for the search agent. And after that, when you will put all the values together, you can see we computed the force for each search agent. The next is acceleration calculation. For this, acceleration is the force into gravitational constant. So we will multiply force with gravitational constant. We will use 100, and we got acceleration. Now you can see here, step 6 is done. We computed the value for gravitational constant, mass, acceleration, and force. Now next step is update position and velocity for each search agent. So using this equation, we can compute velocity. After that, we will add this velocity in the initial position. Here you can see we have velocity, we don't know. So initially we have velocity for each search agent is 0, and this is the random value between 0 and 1, and acceleration that we recently computed. So what we will do, we will put all the values in this equation, and we got the velocity for each search agent. You can see here. Now we will compute the position. For this, we will add velocity in the initial position of each search agent. So for first search agent, we will add the value here, and we got the position for first search agent, for second, third, and fourth one. This step is done. Now next step is evaluate the fitness value again. So again, we will use this fitness function. Put the value here, that is the new values for position you calculated. We will put all the values in this function, and after that you can see we have new fitness value, as you can see here, for each search agent. Let's compare the fitness value You can see the new fitness value, and this is the previous one. We did optimization. You can see this one is optimized, and this one is also optimized, and here this light optimization. So for this we have best fitness value, this one, and the worst fitness value is this one. Step 8 is done. So we will repeat this until the stopping criteria is matched. After that we will return the best solution and stop. So that's just the short introduction about this algorithm. First is the initialization phase. We will initialize the population for the n search agent randomly. After that we will compute the fitness value for the each search agent and increment the counter, set the counter, update the best and worst fitness value, and compute the values for mass, acceleration, gravitational constant, force for each search agent, and update its velocity and position. And we will repeat this process until the stopping criteria is met, and in the end we will return the best solution. So that's just the short introduction about this algorithm. All the calculation that is done in this video, it's my own. So if you found any error, you can, you know, fix it by yourself, or you can just comment below if you found any error. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.